Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping you the applications of artificial neural network. So let's start. So applications of artificial neural network is very wide, and as the time will go, it will go on increasing because it is it gives lots of benefits over a normal network. That's why we are trying to embed it in place of every network. So what are the applications? Let's come on to that one by one. So first application is image processing. Now if you talk about image processing, the main applications are face recognition. Now face recognition, you must be aware of, and the most common example is your mobile device where you use your face to unlock it. So that is like a face recognition that recognizes your face and not of any other face. And another comes face detection, and this is for detecting that there is a face in the picture. Okay, now you must be thinking that whether we use face recognition in our mobile or whether we use face detection in our mobile. So the answer is both, because first we need to detect that is there any face. So for that we use face detection, and once you detect that there is a face, then we use face recognition. So this is how it works in our mobile. Okay, but it has many other applications also of face recognition and face detection. Next is image recognition and image reconstruction. So if we talk about image recognition, now in place of face you need to recognize an image, so that is called as image recognition. And image reconstruction is like if you have a blurred image or if you have a improper image, then you can construct a image from this artificial neural network with the help of artificial neural network. So that is the positive point of this. Next is noise removal. So you can use for noise removal also if there is any noise in your image regarding this. Next is speech processing. So processing of speech to text is also, you can say, the benefits are given by the artificial neural network. The most common example again is present in your smartphone, where you give a speech and that is converted into text. And in same way, text can also be converted to a speech, where when you ask something to your mobile in speech form, then your mobile answers you back. So that is like a text to speech. And then speech recognition, that it recognizes that it is someone's individual speech. So that is speech recognition. Next is healthcare and medicine. So this is, you can say, the most important application in my view. So first application is disease recognition. Now there are different patterns, for example brain tumor or heart disease, there are different patterns. So what we do is we feed this pattern in the artificial neural network, and if they are present in any part of the body, it will automatically detect it. Because humans are prone to an error, but humans can do some error, right? But computers, or you can say artificial neural network in a computer, cannot do. It's very rare that they will miss out something. So that's why we generally take help of artificial neural network for the purpose of finding a disease. Next is computer aided surgery. So now this computer aided surgery is also given importance, where we make use of a computer only that does a surgery that is fed before into the artificial neural network by doctors. Next is defense. Now defense also, you can say it is not that much improved, but still it has been started using in this. So first is unmanned aerial vehicle. Now it is like a UAV, or you can say a vehicle, a aerial vehicle or a flying machine that flies without the you can say without a pilot. So this is generally, you can say, in a form of quadcopter right now, but as time goes on it will increase, and you can say the use of pilot will be decreased. The most common example is, you can see that in general aeroplane also there is a autopilot option, which is the benefit given by ANN only. Next is automated target recognition. So automated target recognition is basically you can recognize, you can make a artificial neural network, and artificial neural network will automatically recognize that where is your target are. So once you recognize your target areas, that where you have to attack, you can better prepare for that attack, right, when you are in war. Next is autonomous soldier robot. Now this is a very positive, you can say, application, because If you are able to design an automated soldier robot, then you don't need to, you will not have loss of lives, right? You can just use take help of robots, and you can say that that will be costly, but not costly than a life. So in this still, you can say information is needed, lot of work is needed, but starting or our initial step has been taken. Next is industry. Now industry we use for repetitive tasks. Like you can take example of automobile industry, where we need to feed same parts in same car again and again and again and again. So rather than using a person, rather than using a individual who will get tired with time, we can use a artificial neural network for that repetitive tasks, that is fitting that car parts in that car again and again. Next is natural language processing, or you can say NLP. So NLP is basically script conversion from English to Hindi. So if you take the example of Google Translator, in old times Google Translator wasn't that good from converting a English language to a Hindi or vice versa, but you can see as the time progressed, as the time went, it went on getting better and better from before. So that is also because of the use of artificial neural network, because in artificial neural network, as the time passes, the system becomes better and better with that particular functionality. In the same way, in area of natural language processing, because it was an artificial neural network that was being used for that purpose, the conversion of English to Hindi, as well as Hindi to English, or you can say any other language to any other language, has been becoming better and better over time. So nowadays, if you use Google Translator, it will give you a much better answer as it would have given you some years ago. Next is bank. Now there is lots of bank, right, in our country and in other countries also. So there is a bank website also. So when you go to a bank website, what you do is you see a chat box at right side bottom, right? Or generally, if you visit you can say website for a passport or for a visa, then what you see is there is a chat box over right side window where there is a person texting you here, and you must have thought like there is a individual sitting in the background who is texting you personally that do you want any help. So that is not a person, that is not an individual, because an individual cannot sit for 24 hours and there are millions of users who will be accessing that website. So we'll be needing millions of individual for replying those millions of people, right? So in place of that, we use chat box for queries, where we feed some predefined questions and equivalent answers to that. So whenever a person is having that doubt which is fed in that chat box predefined, so the chat box answers that this is the particular answer to that particular problem which the customer is having, and this is how chat box are very helpful. Next is automobile. Now in automobile, the best application is self-driving car. So in place of self-driving car, if you take the example of Tesla and all, they are working on that, and you can say that the self-driving car has been used for thousands of kilometers and have been successfully passed, but till now the license of that particular, you can say, feature has not been issued, because still it is considered as a risk, because you are driving a car without a driver. So in the coming times, around 10 to 15 years, you can see more of the self-driving cars on road. And in developed countries, still you can say it has the testing is still going on, and you can say the countries who have made progress in this are USA, China, and other countries are also working on it, but the best models have been prepared by these two. Next is sales and marketing. Now if you talk about sales and marketing, you must be thinking that what is the use of artificial neural network in sales and marketing, why we need that. So in case of that, in sales and marketing, we feed some data, okay, and in according to that data, the artificial neural network that predict that, okay, what should be the price that should be sufficient according to the users also and according to the sellers also, so the seller can also earn some profit, and the customer also doesn't feel bad, and customer doesn't also get lose, right? So that is also application of artificial neural network. Now let me give you a bonus application. A bonus application is simulation of a space. Now in NASA, for simulating a space or simulation of universe or any part of the universe or any part of the space, we take help of artificial neural network that to get the results, okay? Because human can't imagine that what will happen, but artificial neural network actually simulates that, and because of that we have got lot of answers regarding our space, you can say exploration. So this was all about applications of artificial neural network. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.